Hello, massage nurse. Another impromptu video for one of my followers. She left me a comment saying that she's in school now and is having a difficult time remembering medical terminology. And it is very difficult. It's like learning a new language. For those of you that are seasoned therapists, you know it's like learning a new language. However, it is very important for us as professionals to be able to communicate with doctors and nurses and, you know, physiotherapists and physical therapists and other massage therapists. So we must use proper medical terminology. So I'll be giving you a little introduction, and hopefully this helps you and doesn't intimidate you. So let's start by describing what medical terminology is. It is the language used to describe procedures, anatomical structures, conditions, processes, treatments. They are the building blocks of medical terminology. I'll be talking to you about the prefix, the root, and the suffix. Let me start with a root word. It usually comes from Latin or a Greek word, and it is the main subject that you're talking about. Are you talking about the heart? You know, cardi means heart, pulmo means lungs, myo means muscle, cyto means cell, and hepa means liver, and so on and so on. So the root word is the meat and potatoes. What are you talking about? Are you talking about the heart and describing, you know, the condition of the heart? Cardiomyopathy. Cardiomyopathy, you already know that cardio means heart, myo means muscle, opathy means disease. So it is the condition of the heart muscle. It's a disease of the heart muscle. So you break it down. Prefixes usually go at the beginning. Now, root words usually go in the middle. However, not necessarily, because like in cardiomyopathy, the root word is at the beginning. So let's talk a little bit about the prefix, and that usually does the description. You know, how many numbers is it? You know, is it mono means one, di means two, tri means three, and poly means many? Like diaphysis means it has two ends, you know. I'm sorry, I can't think of too many examples, but it describes the number. The number of the whatever it is you're talking about. Speed, it describes the speed, whether, you know, tachy, like tachycardia means too fast. Brady means too slow. The location of maybe where the condition or what you're talking about, you know, the location, like epi means around, like epidural, you know, or around. Intra means inside, you know, intracellular means inside the cell. Inter means between, like interstitial fluid. It's in between the tissues. And, you know, a lot of my students and a lot of people get intra and inter, you know, confused. So intra is inside, inter is in between. It also describes the movement of whatever the subject that you're talking about. Like ab means away from, like abduction, away from the midline of the body. Adduction, you know, putting it back to add it to. It also describes the colors, like leuko means white, erythro, like erythrocytes. Erythro means red, cytes means cell. You know, leukocytes, leuko means white, cytes means cell. So these are white blood cells, red, you know, red. Cyano means blue, like cyanide is the pertaining to the color blue. And chloro means green, like chlorophyll. So, and then again, the root word is the main subject. Then you have your suffix, and that usually goes at the end of the word. And it is the condition of the party part that you are talking about, okay? So let's go into some of them, like ology means the study of, like biology, physiology, psychology, neurology, pathology. So ology, 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 all of that means the study of something. It can indicate the value, the action, the relation to the root word. Like, so it's telling you, what are they doing to that main, you know, to the main root word? Ectomy, you know, is to cut out. So are they having an appendectomy? They're taking out the appendix. tonsillectomy, they're pulling out your tonsils. So anytime you see ectomy is that they're cutting and removing something. Algia means pain, like fibromyalgia, like neuralgia. So anytime you see algia at the end, that means that that person's having pain in that area, whatever the root word is that they're talking about. Scopy or scopy means to examine. So colonoscopy, cystoscopy, that they're looking at that body part. So colonoscopy is the study and going in to look at your colon. So oscopy, that's why you need to know these suffixes, because it's telling you what it's doing to that main root word. Pathy is means disease. So cardiomyopathy means the, you know, the heart muscle, you know, disease. So, you know, this is just to give you an idea. You don't have to remember all of them. You know, just try to remember to break it down. The first thing I, you know, that what I teach my students, the first thing, look at what the root word is. What are they talking about? Are they talking about the heart? You know, are they talking about osteo? Are they talking about the bones? Are they talking about myo, which is, you know, the muscles, or neuro, which is, you know, the nervous system? So first and foremost, find out what the word is talking about. What's the root word? It could be sometimes at the beginning, like cardiomyopathy, or it could be in the middle. But then think, break it down, and then find out, is there a prefix telling you the number? Is it telling you how fast it is, or the location, where it's at, or the movement, or the colors? Start breaking it down and training your brain not to panic, but just to break it down. And then the suffix tells you what it is, the condition of the root word. Is it swollen? You know, like itis. Did I mention itis? I think I forgot to put itis in here, but itis means inflammation. So colitis, inflammation of the colon. Gastritis, you know, inflammation of the gastrointestinal, you know, system. So itis is describing the condition of what's going on with that main root word. So anyway, it's just a matter of breaking it down. Like I said, you don't have to memorize all of them, because there are a lot of them. So just, you know, take a deep breath, figure out which was the root word, and that should help you a little bit to figure out. It's like detective work. That's the thing that I like the most about, you know, anatomy, physiology, and being a massage therapist. We have to do detective work to find out what's going on with a client, how do they injure themselves, you know. So anyway, I like this part. So I hope this helped you, and until the next time, create a great day.